Good morning, everybody. Today is I'll explain about a fading. Fading is the change in signal strength at the receiver, and fading is due to multipath propagation, attenuation of atmosphere, and this fading can be reduced by using a diversity systems to get a sufficient gain and desired signal to noise ratio. Here, fading occurs at receiver, means change in signal strength, at the receiver due to multipath propagation. Yeah, as I said earlier, in space flow propagation, what happens? This is transmitting antenna and this is receiving antenna, and directly the signal travels like this and reflected by surface of Earth. It is Earth. So this is a direct signal and this is an indirect signal, and some signal may be like this and some signal may be like this. So each and every signal, this is S1, S2, S3, and S4 will have different path differences. Their individual electromagnetic wave struggles follows a different path. So path difference of each and every one signals are different. So therefore, all these are the vectors. The resultant signal strength at the receiver will vary, and which is algebraic vector sum. Therefore, its signal strength varies. And another reason why the signal strength is raised at a receiver is attenuation due to rain and atmospheric bulges and some obstacles. All these are the reasons to decrease in attenuation of electromagnetic wave which is coming from the transmitting antenna to the receiver. So because of these reasons, the signal strength varies, and these can be eliminated by using diversity systems. In that, the first diversity system is, in that first one is frequency diversity. And this fading can be reduced with the help of diversity systems. And one such system is a frequency diversity. Frequency diversity. See, here what happens is, due to multipath propagation, signal strength varies, and which can be avoided by slightly changing the frequencies. In this, what happens, transmitter will send two or more frequencies simultaneously. Means one transmitter, this transmitter, and another transmitter. This is a transmitter one and this is a transmitter two, and which sends two or more frequencies into the space, and same signal will be received. Some modeling in information, as the different frequencies will fade differently, and one will always be strong. And here, as the frequency will change, this is F1 frequency and this is F2 frequencies will be radiated by this antenna. And this F1 will fade differently, and F2 will fade differently, and there are many number F tree and a pear on a pen, and many will fade differently. And in this, one frequency signal will be always strong. One frequency will be always strong, which is received by, see how many two transmitters are there at two different frequencies. I transmitted into free space using this antenna. Then again, I require two receivers. This is a frequency receiver which receives the frequency of F1, and this is the receiver 2 is frequency receives F2. So therefore, in this one of the signal will be very, very strong, so that will in this way we can reduce the signal strength variation at the receiver due to fading, due to multipath propagation. And this is a one technique. And second one is space diversity. See why the signal strength is varies at a receiver. Signal strength varies at a receiver because of multipath propagation. So we reduce, if we place antennas at a different places, if we place antennas at different places, then the signal traveled by electromagnetic signals traveled by each and every antenna is also different. Correct or not? See, our fading is different at a different propagation paths in space. In this technique, single transmitter is used. At receiving side, two or more receiving antennas are used at different locations. The signal will fade at one antenna while other antenna output is constant. See here, at one antenna, receiving antenna, it is a vary, and one of the antennas in a receiver side will be constant, means no fading will be taken place at the signal. And base station receiving antennas are usually mounted in such a way to obtain a space diversity. See here, only one transmitter is there. Here, in space diversity, only one transmitter. In space diversity, we have only one transmitter, but many receivers will be there. Say one transmitter. This is a transmitter, and which is radiated by the antenna. And we'll have a different antenna. See, one antenna here, one antenna here, and if the phase difference between, see, this antenna receives a direct signal and non-reflected signal, and this antenna receives a direct signal and some reflected signals. So therefore, here one antenna, see, for one signal, if the path difference between this direct signal and this ground reflected signals is very different, so then definitely this signal strength will vary. But one of such transmitter receivers here, where in which the signal strength is constant, hence it, which indicates that no fading takes place in that path. In this particular path. So therefore, we can say in this way, we can increase the signal to noise ratio. Say signal to noise ratio is one major important parameter in a receiver, where this parameter decides the sensitivity of a receiver, whether the receiver is responding for a weak signals or not. And so because of fading, this sensitivity will be degraded. Then fading, to avoid fading in a speech diversity, we use only one transmitters and many receivers. In many receivers, one of such receiver will be there where there is no any signal strength variations, which indicates that no fading takes place in that particular path. So in this way, we can increase the signal to noise ratio, hence sensitivity also. See, yeah, this phase diversity technique will be used in BTS, base transmitter receiver, BTS. So mobile telecommunication, we use this mobile telecommunication, where each ASIA total total area is divided into three different parts. One is, this is 120 degrees, this is 120 degrees, and this is 120 degrees. And each and one antenna will be placed here in this direction. This one direct, another antenna, this one other antenna. Three different antennas will be placed and to coverage this entire area. So therefore, total area, total sites will be, see, in all broadcast applications, we use this kind of diversity reception system to increase the signal to noise ratio and to provide a better service. And another diversity reception is by which we can improve the signal to noise ratio is the polarity diversity system. Here in these, vertical and horizontal polarization antennas are used to receive the signal. As in the case of space diversity system, the two receivers are connected to produce constant output. So simple one. Here, horizontal antenna, space diversity, one transmitter will be there, and which is radiating electromagnetic signal into space. One antenna, which is a horizontally polarized antenna, receiving antenna, this is R1. Next, another antenna, which is vertically polarized antenna. And here we got another receiver too. And these two are summed together. So here the signal strength is always constant. And less affected by noise. Hence, S by N ratio will be very, very high. Whereas the time diversity, whereas another technique, lost technique, is how to reduce the signal variation at receiver, signal strength variation at receiver is, last one is time diversity. In these, same signals are transmitted at different times. Same signal. See, let us consider this is an antenna, transmitter and transmitting antenna. Here, F1 is transmitted at T1 instant of time, and same F1 is transmitted at T2 instant of time. The fading is time dependent, as time dependent. Hence, some signals are strong and some signals are weak. So means what happens at F1, same frequency signal is transmitted at T1 instant of time, and another same instant of the same frequency signal is being transmitted at T2 instant of time. As we know that a fading is time dependent, hence some signal will be strong and some signal will be weak. So weak, strong signal will be considered. A signal is strong means S by N ratio will become stronger. So therefore, in this way we can achieve the time diversity. So first of all, fading means signal strength, the received signal strength variation at a receiver, and which is due to multipath propagation and attenuation in space. So attenuation anyhow we can't reduce, but this fading can be reduced by using diversity reception systems. One such diversity reception is a frequency diversity, and space diversity, polarity diversity systems, and time diversity systems. And frequency diversity is very, very costly. Why? Because we require two transmitters, two receivers, and which is very not feasible. So hence we go for space diversity here, where we use only one transmitter but many receivers, and still it is improves the S by N ratio, but somewhat is not economic. And a polarity diversity reception system is also we use a different same transmitter and different receivers, and we use two different polarized antennas in polarity diversity reception systems, where the signal strength will be strong at one place, and horizontal and vertical. And these two outputs will be added together, will get a strong signal to noise ratio in a polarity diversity reception systems. And time, whereas a time diversity reception systems, the same signal will be transmitted at different instant of time. So as we know that this fading is a time dependent, and different signals will get a different fading levels and signal strength variations. So we should consider only strong signals so that a signal to noise ratio of any receiver can be improved like that. And thank you so much. This is all about fading. Next class, I am going to explain inductive wave propagation and tropostatic wave propagation.